What's going on, guys? Beastly Gamer here. Welcome to the channel. Today's quick video is a catch-up video of something that's really popular right now, the whole dismantling of the Kinda Funny gang. I call it dismantling because I feel like a very intricate and important part of this group has been removed, and that's Colin Moriarty, the whiz kid, the brains, the guy who has a little bit more tact, and he's more deliberate with his thoughts. And I think that he really was the one that evened out the group. I feel like everybody was kind of on one side politically, he was on the other side, and usually they didn't see eye to eye on their video games, the likes and dislikes of different genres and different games. I thought that he really added a unique voice to the Kind of Funny gang, and I feel like now they're just a bunch of goofballs, and there's really no one there who's an intellectual, and I feel like Colin really added that. But Colin Moriarty went on the Dave Rubin Report last Friday, which was the 17th. He talked at length about the situation with the Kind of Funny guys, and he did allude to things not ending as smoothly as a lot of people have been saying. I know there's a lot of people in the comments who've been saying, Beastly, they ended amicably. Colin decided to do this. Colin just wanted to go off. It's been happening for a long time. It may have been happening for a while. You know, there may have been a separation or a spacing between these entities for a long time, and it may have been growing. But I think this tweet and the way that Kinda Funny gang reacted was the catalyst that sent Colin off. And Colin said on the Rubin Report, I'm paraphrasing, but he said that, I don't want them to fail. I don't want them to not be successful. And if you are the kind of person who actually reads between lines and hears the words between words, that's a far cry from what Colin would have said any other time or any other year. He would have said, I want these guys to be extremely successful. I want them to be happy. I want them to do well. I want them to have the biggest YouTube channel out there. No, he said, I don't want them to fail. I want them to continue on and do what they need to do. And it sounds like there's a lot of love lost between these guys. On the Rubin Report, Colin also alluded to his future and that he would be making an announcement relatively soon on the direction he was going to be going. He also stated that he'd be taking a more politically driven direction with whatever his venture was going to be. And so on Monday, the 20th, Colin Moriarty announced on Twitter and created his new YouTube channel, which is called Colin's Last Stand. And I didn't hear about this until Tuesday morning. My wife actually tweeted it to me or sent me a message while I was in bed in the next room. She sent the message so I could get it first thing in the morning. And I was really shocked and kind of excited to see what Colin was getting into on his own YouTube channel, because the way that things ended with Kinda Funny, it put a really bad taste in my mouth. And I'm not saying that someday in the future I can't, you know, give them my support again, but I just feel like the way that it ended and the way that it seemed so backstabbery, and you know, one thing I don't like to do is call a man a bitch, but they acted like bitches in this situation. They acted like, you've known somebody for this long and you're out in the public eye, you're out in the public sphere, you're in the public arena, you're well-known individuals, and you don't have your person's back. To me, that's just not the way you handle business, and I think Colin probably felt the same way. But Colin, his first video is introducing Colin's Last Stand, and he's sitting in his kitchen in his apartment, and it's quaint, and it isn't a big studio, and he's just being real, and there isn't all these dramatic takes and close-ups, and he's telling you guys what his plans are for this YouTube channel. And I was actually very pleased to hear it. Now, I know a lot of people who are exclusively into video gaming probably won't like Colin's Last Stand as much, but let me just say this. As someone who's not a history major, as someone who just skated by in school, there's been many times listening to Podcast Beyond, listening to the PlayStation podcast, PS I Love You XOXO, where Colin would go off on a tangent and talk about something politically driven or something history driven, or a small little battle that may have happened hundreds of years ago. And he'll start going into detail and talking about it. And as he goes into these, you know, he's going into his comfort zone and kind of explaining to you about the past, and it's really engaging, and it's kind of exciting. I like to learn new things, and so I think this is going to be something really for me. I can find gaming podcasts anywhere. I can listen to, if I really want to hear Greg Miller's opinion on something, I'll go over and listen to him talk about a new PlayStation game. But I think that Colin has something special, and for me, usually the games that he's had an affinity towards are the same ones I've had an affinity towards, and I'm sure that when those games like The Last of Us 2 come out, we're going to hear his opinion on these games. He won't be talking about every single game that comes out, but I'm sure he'll touch on and really give us in-depth thoughts on the games that matter most to him. And in that regard, I think we're still getting Colin. I don't think we're losing Colin. I think we're getting Colin as who he really is on the inside instead of who he's trying to be for a company with separate interests. So, Colin introduced Colin's Last Stand, the YouTube channel, which it, as of right now, has 98,459 views. I don't know if that's actually what you guys are seeing right now, because that's a pictures earlier. But that's a good start for the very first video, and it's only 2 days old, 100,000 views. He also mentioned his Patreon page, which excited me. And I found out about this yesterday, which was Tuesday. That he had a Patreon, and I went to his Patreon, and I was kind of shocked, because apparently lots of us from the Kind of Funny community have decided to go on over and support the man Colin Moriarty. So there's at this moment 5,592 patrons. These are people who pledge a monthly donation to Colin Moriarty and his new venture, Colin's Last Stand. As of right now, Colin is receiving $37,112 per month. And that's super duper exciting for me. I know it's exciting for him and his girlfriend, Erin, and their future. They plan on moving out of the location they're at now in California. Who knows if they'll stay in that state or not. But he's making real life-changing plans. I distinctly remember last year or the year before. It may have been the year before, right when Colin and Greg left IGN. Colin actually said, it wasn't Greg, it was Colin. He said, we'll probably live, I'll tell you now, I'm going to live with this guy until the day I die. So a lot has changed in a very short period of time. Now he's got the love of his life, the beautiful Erin, he's got a little puppy. And more than likely with this new venture and him being able to set aside time as needed to really focus on the kind of quality videos he wants to do, he's going to do two per week. You know, he was looking for a $10,000 per month goal. And he over tripled that and almost quadrupled it. So I'm sure he's going to have a little more expendable cash for the equipment that he says he needs to get. New cameras, which I need myself. Send me a few dollars, Colin. He needs new camera and he really wants a new microphone because I'm sure he states that the audio quality means a lot to him. So he'll definitely be able to do that. And they'll probably be able to go off and live wherever they want to and create the kind of content that's conducive to his success. But it's really mind-blowing to me that in a matter of hours, yesterday, when I woke up, right after this was already announced, he was already at $32,000. I tweeted at him, and he said, thank God to everybody out there, already reached $10,000 worth of patrons. Thank you so much. And I said, wow, Colin, 32. You know, the community has your back. And that's just really breathtaking to me, that so many of us have taking a little bit from ourselves to give to someone who means something. It might be just an insignificant thing to a lot of people. A lot of people don't have expendable income, but to take a little out of your pocket and give to someone because you like who they are as a person and you like what they contribute to your life means a lot. On the other hand, it's kind of funny to see what's happened here. Now let's look at Colin's page, Patreon. He's got $37,112 donated every month. Let's go to Kind of Funny. And look at theirs. Kind of Funny has 8,316 patrons, $26,110 per month. Now, Kind of Funny lost about $10,000 or more dollars right within the first 2 or 3 days after Colin left. So that was a big hit. I'm sure it feels like a huge hit to them at this point because the money that they accrue through Patreon has to be split four ways. It's Greg Miller, it's Tim Geddes, Nick Scarpino, and Kevin. And who gets probably very little of the kitty, but that's $26,110 for Kind of Funny. Kind of Funny Games, their sub channel, also has a Patreon, which has 5,925 patrons at $20,164. So they have a total between both of their channels with four guys of $40,274. 40,000 versus Collins, 37 after 2 days. I think Colin's doing pretty good. If you guys are interested, more than likely you already found it, but Colin's YouTube channel, I'll put a link to it in the description. You guys can click on that and go over and subscribe and get ready for it. Let me just say this, for the guys and gals out there who might not be too politically inclined or motivated to learn about politics, let me just tell you this. there is a line. There's a place in your life where you cross this line where things become more adult to you, and it's no longer the Nintendo, but you're trying to figure out what the future for you and your family is, and then it begins to really matter who's in control of the country and who's in control of different parts of your town or your city or your state. You want to know who's making decisions and what they're doing on your behalf and if it's going to hurt you or your family's business. These kind of things really matter. And you might not know it now, but it's very important to learn what's going on politically around you. And Colin's one of those guys that kind of makes it enjoyable to learn about. So I would say, if you like Colin Moriarty, if you like his wit, if you like his banter, and you like what he's passionate about, you want to learn more about politics, I would definitely tell you guys to subscribe to Colin's Last Stand. I think it's going to be a great channel. He's announced that his first video will be going live on April 3rd. So it's just a few days away. We've got just about 10 days left until that big pronouncement of his first video. I think it's going to be awesome. I can't wait. And like he said, there'll be two videos per week. But I wanted to give you guys some more quick statistics on what's going on in the world of Kinda Funny, because I'm sure right now to those guys, things are looking kinda strange. Let's go on over to Kinda Funny's Social Blade. And if you guys don't remember, Social Blade's the website you can go to check the analytics numbers, subscribers, and views for pretty much any YouTube channel. They also cover other things like Twitch. But Kinda Funny's YouTube channel, still a B ranking, they've actually dropped in subscribers for the last 30 days and views for the last 30 days. Now, since March 13th, which is the day that Colin announced that he was stepping down from Kinda Funny, they've lost subscribers consistently, hundreds every single day. And the very first day was the most. And apparently today, which it's still early, it's 5:30, they've only lost 198 today. But you got to take into account there have been people still subscribing on these days, and every single day there's more and more people leaving than there are people coming. They're at the point right now where I think they've only lost a few thousand subscribers. Even with the people coming in, they've lost about 3,000 or 4,000 subscribers. But the daily averages, as per Social Blade, states that they're losing an average of 94 subs a day. A few days ago, when I gave you guys the update on their channel, they were only losing 2 subscribers a day. So I don't know if this is going to continue to happen. They're still getting their views. So they're still getting their pay. I honestly think that Greg Miller needs to address the elephant in the room. There's tons of negative comments on all the Kinda Funny videos. There's tons of dislikes. At this point, the dislikes have kind of subsided a little bit. I'm seeing 70, you know, it's 30 to 70, 30% dislikes at this point, just about. Some videos are higher than others, but there's a lot of dislikes. You know, there's 677 just on this video. There's 983 likes. So that's still a lot of people who are feeling disgruntled and dissatisfied with the way the situation was handled. I think that Greg needs to put away the character for a while, look in the camera, and tell people that this ended in a way that the viewers maybe don't understand fully, and plead with his viewers and his subscribers to stick around and continue to support their company and their efforts. That's what I would do. Obviously, a lot more people than Greg and Tim and Nick thought are really pissed off about the situation, and it goes to show, you know, between these four guys, they got $41,000, and Colin now has $38,000 by himself. So, I mean, that's got to be a kind of a huge wake-up call for them at this point to say, oh, wow, Colin, he's beating us. He's making a lot more money than we are by himself, sitting in a kitchen without, he doesn't have to pay for the studio anymore. He doesn't have to pay for anything. He's sitting in the kitchen making a lot more money than us because people feel slighted. People feel slighted by you guys. I feel slighted by you. I feel like you're a fake friend, Greg. You know, that's the way I feel. I feel like, you know, you guys showed your true colors when the chips were down. And I think that Greg needs to put away his character. You know, that's who he is. He's a character all the time, and he has an issue turning it off. He needs to turn the character off, look in front of the camera, look into the eyes of his subscribers and his viewers and his best friends, and make a plea and tell them that this ended poorly. They weren't 100% honest about the way that it ended. They felt a certain way, and Colin felt a certain way, and it maybe erupted, because that's the way I feel like this thing happened. I feel like these guys are professional enough to keep that, you know, suppressed and not show the viewers exactly what happened. But I feel like there was a big altercation, And I feel like everybody piled on against Colin, and that was the straw that broke the camel's back. And Greg needs to acknowledge that, and he needs to let people know the truth, that things could have ended better, and he wishes that they did, and he really apologizes if people feel like he let them down by the way that he dealt with Colin's tweet, by tweeting out this ridiculous apology letter that had period blood all over it. It was just so stupid. It seems like he should have been wearing a pussy hat when he wrote it. It's pathetic. But there are some people out there who watch these videos. Like, for instance, this video I was just talking about on Kind of Funny, who still have a very positive outlook. And those are the kind of best friends that Greg and the team at Kind of Funny have been kind of cultivating and nurturing. And this one particular person called The Poncho Pilgrim says, "Dudes, chill out. Go watch Colin's Last Stand. Stay here. Watch Kind of Funny. Support both." And in some of the comments below, you know, I just kind of got to agree with them. The World Spin Nagato, which is a Naruto reference, says, "I'm just going to support Colin's Patreon for now. Going to stay on the fence a little with Kind of Funny. Or kind of. I don't think the content will be worth a Patreon sub for me, but wish them the best. Well, kind of." And the Poncho Pilgrim replied. He said, "Fair enough. I'm talking from the perspective of someone who doesn't support either on Patreon. I just mean general support for their content." And he got some thumbs up, and I'll actually give a thumb up for that, because, you know, that's being an optimist. But someone named Drew M87 said, "It's not that easy for a lot of people, and it may sound stupid, but Kind of Funny has become kind of fake to me, and I think a lot of other people feel the same way when they hear about the behind-the-scenes fighting or the stuff Colin said on the Rubin Report about feeling abandoned, etc. I think a lot of people are on the same boat as me, where we find it hard or don't know how to move forward supporting Kind of Funny anymore after the way everything went down. It just seems that Kind of Funny is, as a whole, is just fake, and that the community, to some people, that Kind of Funny consists of is just a means to an end, to be used and manipulated for certain people's gains. It's telling because both Kind of Funny Patreons have gone down drastically in the last 24 to 48 hours with Colin's exploding. Also, Kind of Funny, with the way everything went down, I think has lost a lot of trust with a lot of people. This doesn't mean that everyone agrees that the joke wasn't offensive. I don't think it was. And that's simply why they're supporting Colin. I think for some people it goes way deeper than that. Others can speak up for themselves, but for now, I can't look at Kind of Funny the same way anymore. Maybe through time I will, but I'm not a fan of what's happened to Kind of Funny recently. Didn't like a lot of the changes with the morning show, etc., but meh, whatever, to each his own. As Colin says himself, we can agree with each other, but let's be civil about it. Rant over. And Press Hardy says, Colin's already raised more money than Kind of Funny. That's nuts. And then they start rambling on about the money. Drew, that was a great response, and I gotta say I agree with you wholeheartedly. At some time in the future, maybe Greg Miller and these guys can win over the audience. And maybe they'll continue to be successful. Who knows just how hard this is going to hit them. But you can't unsee the way this happened. You know, you hear Greg Miller and Tim Geddes saying, "Oh, everything's fine, man. Snow cones and rainbows. Everything just, it was fantastic." Colin said, "Hey, man, you guys want me to leave and go try my own thing? I mean, I'll leave if you guys are okay with it." And they were like, "Well, I don't care. Do you care? No? No? Okay, you can go." It didn't happen like that. It was a very bad situation that happened, and Colin's the only one kind of alluding to the truth. He even said it himself. "Maybe one day you guys will get together and talk about what really happened." I'm sure he's open to it, because I don't think Colin's a liar. I think Colin probably feels bad about not telling the truth. He probably feels like Kojima, like he can't tell the truth because you guys don't want to tell the truth. That's a real fucked up situation to be in. But after this whole situation with Kind of Funny, I just feel like they have no virtue. They're a group of empty shells doing whatever it takes to get people to lure people in and get people over to Patreon. You know, I admire 100% you guys' work ethic, but you have to have more ethics than work ethic to me. And so I'm really happy that Colin is doing well. I look forward to April 3rd, his first video for Colin's Last Stand. And Colin, I don't think you'll have to make any more stands. I think that the stand you just made is the most important one, and we have your back, my friend. You guys let me know what you think in the comments below. Kind of Funny, seeing a huge dip on both of their channels. They've been losing subscribers every single day. I'm going to get back with you guys in a couple of weeks, probably in 2 or 3 weeks, to talk about how Colin's new channel is going. and what's going on with Kinda Funny, and whether or not Greg and the team over at Kinda Funny have the fortitude to come out and really address the giant pink elephant that's sitting in the corner. They need to talk to people. They need to quit being the character, Greg. Be a real fucking human being and look people in the eye and say, hey, look, this ended this way, and we were trying to just, you know, keep sugarcoat it and make you guys think that it ended on better terms, but it didn't end. You guys are best friends, and the fact that Colin does not even call you a friend anymore, Greg, and you try to pretend that, you know, everything is fine, how stupid do you think we are? We've been following you morons for years. I say morons in a very endearing way. I call friends morons. But we've been following you guys for years. And we've seen your friendship blossom, and we know how fucking close you and Colin are, or how close you were, so something you did recently really screwed the pooch. He doesn't even call you a friend anymore. He didn't even cite you in his letter on Facebook. None of you guys. Yeah, obviously, he felt like somebody sold him the fuck out. And I'm really happy for everybody out there who's supporting Colin. Thank you all. I also support Colin Moriarty and his ventures in the future, and I look forward to seeing what he does with this channel. We get at least 2 videos a week. I'm super excited to learn more about history and politics and a little bit of sprinkle of video games on the side. You guys let me know what you think about this whole situation in the comments below. Do you think Kinda Funny is done? I see a lot of people saying Kinda Funny is over. I find it a little hard to believe that Kinda Funny is just over, you know. I think that Kinda Funny will suffer a little bit. And at the end of their suffering, they're going to learn a lesson. And they've got to come out and be real with their fan base in order for it to start growing again. Because people like Colin and Greg because it took us a long time to figure out who they were. We watched IGN for video game news, and then all of a sudden we started listening to these two nerds talk about video games, and we started to like them. And they became, you know, stress relief. They became our entertainment for an hour every week on Podcast Beyond. We began to listen to them and look forward to them. And then they became a part of our lives. They crept into our lives and became something that we look forward to every week. Then they left IGN and they started something that we could get every single day. And now that thing is over. But I think that once Kinda Funny actually opens up that door to be real with people and say, hey, look, things didn't end the way that we said they did. It was a little bit more hostile. And, we really apologize for it. Everybody was heated. Nobody's perfect. And we'd like to ask you guys, you know, to talk to us about it. We'll talk to you about it. You don't got to come straight out and apologize. But I think what you guys did was really, there's some pussy shit. I don't really speak like that. But you guys acted like a bunch of bitches on Twitter. And it was totally uncalled for. And it was just kind of sad. You guys let me know what you think in the comments. Hope you guys enjoyed this little catch-up video. Colin's Last Stand. Doing great. 2 days already at 40 grand. This guy is killing it. It's going to be a good year for you, Colin. You and Aaron are going to have some great vacations. Be sure to give a thumbs up, guys. Show support for the channel. Join the Facebook group. Follow me on Twitter. And you can share your videos and your thoughts at BeastlyGamer.com. I'm the Beastly Gamer. I'll see you guys next time.